In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to control the onboard LED with a touch sensor. For this tutorial, you'll need an Arduino, a touch sensor, and 3 jumper wires, male to female. If you don't have these jumper wires, you can also use a breadboard and 3 jumper wires male to male. The first step is to connect your jumper wires to the touch sensor PCB. The touch sensor is actually a resistor. When you touch the PCB, the resistance will increase. Therefore, the PCB can detect that you've touched the sensor and sends the signal high to the Arduino. Now it's time to connect our touch sensor to the Arduino. The red wire is connected to the 5 volt, the blue wire is connected to the ground, and the green wire is connected to pin 8. Our circuit is now complete. Let's have a look at the code for this circuit. The code is pretty straightforward. If you look at line 19, we set pin number 8 as an input. On line 20, we use the LED built-in constant to define the built-in LED. We set it as an output. The advantage of using LED built-in instead of pin 13 is that for the Arduino Uno, you have pin 13 with the built-in LED. But for example, for the Mega, it could be some different pin. So with this constant, you're absolutely sure that you have the correct pin for the built-in LED. Then we make sure that the LED is turned off by doing a digital write to the LED built-in pin and set it to low. Then we continue to the very small loop. What we do is we read on pin number 8, to which our sensor is connected, and check if the value is high. If so, we turn the LED on, and if not, we turn it off. Then we wait for 100 milliseconds and the loop continues. So basically it checks 10 times per second if the touch sensor has been touched and turns the LED on and off accordingly. I'm now going to upload this code to my Arduino and show you what it looks like. I've uploaded the code to my Arduino, and when I touch the sensor, you see this onboard LED marked with the L lit up. When I press it, you see it's on. And now it's off when I release my finger. On and off. We're now going to implement debounce on this. In this second part, we're going to add the so-called debounce to our touch sensor. Debounce means that the touch is only triggered once in a defined period of time. And I'll show you this in a minute. First, we start with some new variables. We have the previous millis, which is an unsigned long since we're going to store milliseconds in that. And the same goes for the elapsed millis. Then we have a LED state, which is the state of the LED, and that's low because we want to turn it off when we start. Here we have the debounce time in milliseconds, and that's the amount of time which has to be between two triggers of the touch sensor. So when I touch the touch sensor multiple times within these 1000 milliseconds, the Arduino only sees a stopped once. The setup is basically the same. We define pin 8 as an input, we set the LED built-in as an output, and we turn the built-in LED off. So in the loop, something has changed. We store first in elapsed millis the amount of milliseconds minus the previous milliseconds. And these millis are the amount of milliseconds since the Arduino was turned on. Then we have an if statement, and instead of just checking whether pin number 8 is high, we also check if the elapsed time is larger than the debounce time. Remember, if this isn't the case, we don't have to look any further because we only want our touch sensor to be triggered once every debounce time. So then we're going to check the LED state. If it was high, we make it low, or else we make it high. So basically this toggles the LED. And then we write this new LED state to the LED built-in pin. So it goes on or off depending on the LED state here on line 44 or 46. And if so, we store the previous millis, or sorry, the current millis in the previous millis. And we do this so that this calculation here with the elapsed millis, here is the previous millis, is the same as this one. So we can see that there is enough time elapsed when we want to calculate this condition. I'm now going to upload this code to the Arduino Uno and show you what it looks like. I've uploaded the debounce code to my Arduino, and as you can see, the LED is off. When I press gently on the touch sensor and wait for a second, you see the LED goes on and off. Because of our debounce, there is only one possibility to change every second. Because if I tap quickly, you still see the LED is changing every second. So the debounce prevents that we change the LED continuously and it will blink. If we increase the debounce time to, for example, 10 seconds, you can only turn it on and off every 10 seconds. This concludes our tutorial about the touch sensor. You've learned how to read the state of the touch sensor and how to add debounce to the sensor. If you have any questions, feel free to drop them in the comments. And for the circuit diagram and the course material, there's a link in the description below this video. I see you in the next episode.